I discovered Whitney when she was just going on 19.
Clive came to showcase half hour late. He walked in, I sang if I had, you know, did what I had to do, and then he left. I didn't think that he was very excited about it or anything, but then I got a call saying that he really wanted to sign me and that he really wanted me.
Whitney Houston's first album sold nearly 20 million copies, the most successful debut in music business history.
She and I, from day one, have worked as creative partner. She trusted me, she was new, and indeed, we started this incredible career together.
With her second album, Whitney became the first artist ever to garner 7 number one hits in a row, breaking the previous record held by the Beatles. Listen to an early version of one of the songs Davis carefully chose for his diva-to-be.
Now, you hear that and you think, yes, it'll work for Whitney. No, it won't work for Whitney.
I certainly thought it would work for Whitney, but Whitney would breathe different kind of life. That was a pure pop demo.
And as we all know, it came out sounding like this.
For an Aretha Franklin, for Whitney Houston, geniuses of the voice, they have got to know what the best songs that are currently being written, so that you've got to know who is writing the best songs, who's producing it, arranging it, and yes, you've got to keep vigilant. You hold